Where are we going?
We're going to Whole Foods.
Woo! All right, we're on the search for vegan donuts.
Vegan.
Whole food. Cilantro. What is that, Tyler?
A young Thai coconut.
Okay, this is the second best section of Whole Foods. Fresh orange juice. Organic. Say turmeric. Yeah, not turmeric.
Turmeric?
That's not where this stress level is. Okay, let's just see how much this is. Okay, this is $3.99 a pound. Tyler almost bought two of them for $60. Crazy. Online, because he's so desperate to try it. So I guess he's gonna buy it. I didn't realize it was so big.
I don't know how to tell if they're right or not.
I have no idea.
Should we ask someone?
This one looks good.
My first jackfruit ever.
This is documented. So Tyler, who did we just meet?
We met some dude from Jamaica who told us about the jackfruit.
Yeah, he was telling us how it grows off of the root of the tree and that it's the first time he's seen them here at Whole Foods or here in the U.S.
No one knows what it is.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. It's getting a lot of stares. We're excited.
Yo, check it out, guys. My first jackfruit ever. $52, it was over 13 pounds. This thing is gonna be insane. Hopefully it tastes good.
Okay, so Tyler and I got this jackfruit yesterday from Whole Foods and it's already bad. It's like moldy and shit. So we're gonna cut it open today and we're gonna try it. Luna's gonna help us.
Hopefully it's not that bad.
And hopefully it's not bad, yeah.
But we shall see.
So we have no idea what we're doing, but all the videos say that you put oil on the knife. So that's step one. Whoa.
It looks okay.
I'm gonna eat a piece of it.
Are you?
It's good. I'm not sure why this is $50 though. What do you think?
It is very sweet.
Yeah, it's good.
It is good, not $50 worth.
No. Not $50 worth.
Nope.
Okay, so moral of the story is it's really good, and we definitely recommend you try it, but maybe when you're in Asia,
yeah.
And it's like $2. Okay, so we made a lot of progress. This is, I guess, the shells of everything. These are the seeds that we're taking out. We're going to replant them in Florida. And then this is the flesh that we're going to eat.
What it looks like right here.
Yeah, these are the polyps.
Things. You want to separate all these little parts right here. Kind of hard.
And then you get into the middle and get that.
Doing work, son.
That seed. Alba, you contacted me earlier and you were saying how you still want to eat honey. And it's funny because Tyler and I were having a discussion about this just the night before. And because I don't eat honey and he does, but he's been vegan for longer than I have. So I'm just going to let Tyler give you his point of view, then I'll give you my point of view, and then you can decide what you want to do.
Woo! All right, so I think honey is acceptable. I mean, usually when they keep bees, they're not, like, killing the bees, you know? They just kind of smoke them out, like filming the jackfruit. And also there's, you know, with technology and stuff, there's a new sustainable way to collect honey. And I think honey is a nutritional substance, you know? I haven't really read too much bad information on it.
Talk about the bee pollen.
And dairy, yeah, and bee pollen as well. That's one of the most nutritionally dense foods on the planet. It has every vitamin and mineral, every nutrient that the human body needs. So I usually try to take bee pollen every single day. It's like my daily multivitamin made by the bees. It takes one bee working like 40 hours a week. To make just a teaspoon of bee pollen or something like that. Something ridiculous. So you can imagine the energy that goes into that food. So, and it's just loaded with antioxidants and enzymes and everything like that. So bee pollen is really, really good. And it's just made from the pollen of the plants, which is the male sperm of the plants. So it's plant material, but it's processed by the bees themselves, just in a way that activates all the enzymes and makes it a complete food.
It's fine, obviously, to call yourself vegan with even if you eat honey, because I think it's something that.
And you should, yeah, you shouldn't put a label on yourself. Like,
yeah.
If you want to be vegan and eat like bee products, like, you don't need to put a label on yourself. Like, ooh, I'm a vegetarian now that I eat honey. Like, don't put a label on yourself. Just eat healthy. Don't eat animal products. You know, if you want to eat honey, then eat honey. If you don't want to eat honey, then don't eat honey. If you don't feel comfortable with it, it's whatever you feel comfortable with. But I would say anything other than honey is not really too acceptable. Like, obviously, dairy and meat and eggs are totally unsustainable and, you know, unhealthy. There's
yeah.
scientific evidence, you know.
You know, but the problem is when you start getting so specific about everything that it becomes hard to live your life. That becomes a problem. You know what I mean? You just need to do the best you can and be conscious of the decisions that you make. Wow, we finished. This is crazy.
Woo! Look at all that jackfruit, Courtney.
I think it's not going to tip up very well.
That's awesome.
And,
you got a shit ton of jackfruit.
I don't eat honey. I don't eat bee pollen, but I've never really been a big fan of honey, so I don't think that it's necessary for me. I think that it's I think that's your choice, and I don't judge Tyler or judge anyone for eating honey, but I think it is something like Tyler was saying, the bees work so hard to make it. The bees need it. It's for the bees and their survival. And the bees are so essential to our environment. So it's like, I don't even like it. Like, there's other substitutes, like agave nectar. There's tons of other nectars. Like, even maple syrup is really sweet. And I just don't find it necessary. And so I don't eat it.
You should replace your products over time and not worry about your past, you know, choices and decisions when you were, you know, uneducated about the specifics about all of it and everything, and then just start integrating more vegan products into your lifestyle. But I think the biggest one is diet.
Veganism is about compassion, about caring for others, like humans and animals alike. You know, we want to care for everyone. We want to have people to have good work environments. We want to buy products that promote sustainability and promote equality for animals and humans, and just trying to incorporate that in your life without killing yourself and without making it so difficult. That's what we think.
Woo! The vegan duo.
Brother and sister.
Tyler and Courtney.
Live my day as if there was no past. Doing it all night, all summer. Doing it the way I wanna. Yeah, I'ma dance my heart out till the dawn. But I won't be done when morning comes. Doing it all night, all summer. Gonna spend it like no other. Couldn't get enough. It was a rush, but I gave it up. It was a crush. Now I might have wanna say too much, but that's all it was, so I gave it up. I live my day as if it was the last. Live my day as if it was no past. Doing it all night.
So I thought that this rock was stable, and it's not. My whole leg just got soaking wet. Oh, Luna's like, you're an idiot.
Doing it the way I wanna. Yeah, I'ma dance my heart out till the dawn. But I won't be done when morning comes. Doing it all night, all summer. Gonna spend it like no other. It was a crush. I kept saying I'ma stay in touch. But that thing went bust, so I gave it up.
Downtown DC, we just parked. It's like 17 an hour or 11 an hour. It's so fucking annoying. But
expensive. That should be expensive.
Okay, so we just made it to the Botanical Garden, and we just passed the Capitol. It's under construction right now, so it's not so pretty. Holy shit, you scared me so bad. Oh my god.
When low, when high, still waters run. Gotta get back in the groove. I ain't ever heard it. When low, when high, what matters is enough. Getting right back in the mood. I live my day as if it was the last. Live my day as if there was no past. Doing it all night, all summer. Doing it the way. no pass. Doing it all night, all summer. Doing it the way I wanna. Yeah, I'ma dance my heart out till the dawn, but I won't be done when morning comes. Doing it all night, all summer. Gonna spend it like no other. Now I found another crush. Lush life giving me a rush. Had one chance to make me blush. Second time is one to let.
We saw our childhood best friends. We grew up with them. Keegan and Keely.
Woo!
Shout out to Keego.
Woo! Luna's excited. Luna, your face looks morphed in this camera. Yeah, we saw Keegan and Keely. It was super great seeing them. If you're watching this, shout out. We love you guys. Thanks for having dinner with us. And choosing a vegan-friendly place. We appreciate it. Have a good night.
Bye.